I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and in this video, I'll be going over how you can lower your blood sugars quickly. I've been living with type 1 diabetes since 1997. I'll be letting you in on the three ways that I've found lower your blood sugars most effectively here and now. And then in the end, as a little added bonus, I'll also be adding one trick that can help you improve your blood sugars in the long run. If you live with diabetes, managing your blood sugar is a daily chore. And sometimes our blood sugars don't quite behave as we expect them to, and we'll end up with a high blood sugar. And normal blood sugar for a person not living with diabetes is usually between 70 and 130 milligrams per deciliter. But if you do live with diabetes, you might find that sometimes your blood sugars do not fall in that range, or maybe a lot of times they don't fall in that range. What you define as a high blood sugar for you might not be the same as what I define as a high blood sugar for me, but actually I don't think it matters. If a blood sugar of 130, 160, 200, if that's a high blood sugar to you, if that's too high for you, then it's time to do something about it. So let's talk about some of the ways that you can use to lower your blood sugars quickly. Aerobic activities such as going for a walk or a bike ride can be incredibly effective in lowering blood sugars here and now. And aerobic activities, anything that raises your heart rate, not all the way up, but raises your heart rate and keeps it up. How long you have to be active for before you see an impact on your blood sugars is a little individual. For me, it's usually about 30 minutes, but you might already see an impact on your blood sugars after 10 to 15 minutes. A little word of caution though. If you live with insulin-dependent diabetes and you have absolutely no insulin on board, or you have very, very little, doing an activity, even such as walking, can actually make your blood sugars go even higher. You also need to be aware that if your blood sugar is higher than 240 milligrams per deciliter, you have to be careful. So if it's that high, you need to check for ketones. If you have moderate to severe ketones and you don't know why, you should go to the ER. Don't start walking around your neighborhood, okay? You can check for ketones very easily using a ketone kit stick. So these are over the counter, and it's basically just these sticks that you pee on, and you compare it to the color here to see if you have ketones or not. The next tip is to adjust your medication. If you live with insulin-dependent diabetes, this might be the time to inject more rapid-acting insulin. So it's like a Humalog, your Novolog, your Apidra. You do have to be careful not to overdose though. So if you've injected rapid-acting insulin in the last 2 to 3 hours, I would be very cautious about injecting more. Think about it like this. Rapid-acting insulin, again, Humalog, Novolog, Apidra, those kind of insulins, once you inject them, they don't start to work until 15 minutes after injected. And they don't peak, so that means they're not the most effective until an hour, maybe an hour and a half after you injected them. And furthermore, they will last in your body 3 to 5 hours. So you need to think about these things. So if you only just injected rapid-acting insulin an hour ago, you might just need to give it a bit of time to actually do its job. If you use an insulin pump, you have to consider there might be a pump malfunction of some sort. So the trick to that is to do a manual injection using a syringe and see if that actually lowers your blood sugars. If it does, you might have to change your infusion set or maybe even your cartridge. If you're using other blood sugar lowering medications, you might want to consider, hey, did you maybe miss a dose? So please have a conversation with your medical team about what to do in situations where you do miss a dose, because it could happen. So do they want you to take the whole dose once you remember, maybe half the dose, or do they want you to wait it out and not take it until your medication is planned? And now I want you to ask yourself, are you hydrated? So that leads us to the third way of lowering your blood sugars quickly. For us living with diabetes, hydration is even more important. Even mild dehydration, so you wouldn't even necessarily notice that you dehydrated, but even mild dehydration can lead to blood sugars 50 to 100 milligrams per deciliter higher than if you are hydrated. Those are the three ways that I found are most effective at lowering blood sugars here and now. So that was aerobic activity, I prefer walking, it's adjusting medication, and it's staying hydrated. But I also promise you a bonus tip on how you can improve your blood sugars in the long run by improving your insulin sensitivity. If you want to increase your overall insulin sensitivity, meaning how well your body utilizes the insulin that you either inject or that your body makes, the golden key is anaerobic exercise, such as resistance training. Resistance training is anything that puts your muscles under tension. So that can, for example, be body weight exercises, think squats, push-ups, or you can be using equipment such as weights or resistance bands. The beauty of resistance training is that it can lower blood sugars for up to 24 hours after even just 20 minutes of intense exercise. I do want to mention that you might see your blood sugars go up during high intensity training. That's quite normal. If you have enough insulin on board, that should come down by itself right after. And you can always utilize a walk to get it down a little faster. A few safety notes. So I did mention ketones, and I do want to bring that up again, because if you develop ketones as someone living with diabetes, you are at high risk of going into DKA, diabetes ketoacidosis. And as I did mention earlier, guidelines say don't exercise if you have moderate to severe ketones. If blood sugars are 250 and you don't have ketones, the guidelines, linked to them up here, do state that you could do mild to moderate exercise. However, intense exercise should be delayed until blood sugars are below 250 milligrams per deciliter. As I kind of mentioned that before as well, high intensity exercise can actually make blood sugars go up during exercise. If you have frequent high blood sugars, you might want to consult with your medical team. It could mean that your current diabetes management just needs some adjustment. And that is all from me today. I hope you found this video informative. And if you liked it, please give it a like below and leave me a comment with your most effective way of lowering your blood sugars. Also, if you find my content helpful, please click the subscribe button and you'll be informed whenever I post new content. Thank you so much for watching.